Hey, what's up everyone? My name is Franklin Okafor Ebechukwu and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is my first video on YouTube and today I'm going to start off by sharing some tips for the upcoming West African Senior Secondary Certification Examination, which is the WASSCE exam. By the grace of God and by burning the midnight oils, I was able to score 9 A1s out of 9 subjects in my WASSCE examination. So today, in this video, I'm going to be sharing some tips, you know, shedding some light on what I did to be able to achieve such accolade. So without any further ado, let's just get straight to the video. So the first thing that I'm going to mention that I think was very important and key is dropping any form of distractions. Now, distractions could be friends, it could be social media, especially social media, your TikToks, your Netflix, your Instagram, your Twitter, any form of social media at all that could pose a serious distraction to you. It is very advisable that you drop such while preparing for this examination, even though you have like 6 months or thereabouts to the WASSCE examination. It's very important because when you distract yourself, you're not going to have enough time to be able to read and, you know, garner some info, necessary information that you need in the WASSCE examination. So our advice, the first thing you want to do is to drop all sorts of distractions. If it's a friend that is always calling you to come play or have some fun all the time when you are supposed to be reading, I think you have to drop that friend. If it's a social media, you should drop any form of distraction at all. Please and please make sure to drop them as you are preparing for this examination. The second tip that I would like to mention has to be study tips. So I know that's what a lot of people are waiting for. How did I read? When do I read? Where do I? That kind of stuff. So now, to discuss study tips, I'm going to be breaking it down into 3 sections. Now, number 1 is going to be study schedule. Number 2 is going to be your study space. And number 3 is going to be, how I read, the study habits. Yeah, that's the way to put it, study habits. So the first thing has to be study schedule. So to be organized, I'll advise that if you're preparing for the WASSCE examination, if you are a serious type, you're a serious student and you are looking to make at least 7 A's or above, you should already have come up with a study schedule. And now a study schedule means, okay, what you're going to read, what course or what subject you're going to read, and the time or the day, like when you read that subject, all right? So you should have a draft of, okay, Monday I'm going to cover biology or I'm going to cover government, Tuesday I'm going to practice math or I'm going to read on economics, Friday I'm going to cover on photography or civic education, something like that. You should always have a plan or a schedule. So having a schedule keeps you organized and you don't have to wake up and think about, what do I have to read today? And you know, that makes you disorganized, and at the end of the day you might end up not reading at all. So having a schedule helps you to be more organized and helps you to be more productive. The second part of study tips is going to be study space. Now, study space is very important, and I got this from Atomic Habits by James Clear, that your motivation is actually overrated, but if you work in an environment, a space that is well organized, well kept, and has people that can motivate you or anything like that, you're more likely to achieve more than when you work in a space that is dirty, that is clumsy and very disorganized. So in the long run, what I'm trying to say is your study space actually affects how much you can achieve, how much you can garner, how much knowledge you can acquire within whatever allotted time you have for studying. So our advice, as you prepare for your WASSCE, pick spaces that are quiet. If you're someone that can't study in a noisy place, pick spaces that are quiet. When I was in school, I loved picking quiet. I always had spots where I used to read, and most times I'm always there on my own, except maybe one of my friends just joins me. And when we're reading together, we know, okay, we're not supposed to talk too much. We're not supposed to make noise or, you know, crack some funny jokes, except maybe when we were just strolling or something like that. But when we study, we know that this is time for studying, and we put all our minds and all our hearts into studying for that particular period of time, and after that we could have fun or joke around or something like that. So please and please make sure you find a good study space. The next one is going to be study tips. All right. So for the study tips, there are a lot of study tips that I'm going to give for WASSCE especially. And number one study tips is, I would advise people, a lot of students actually read, they don't study. There's a difference between reading and studying. Now, when you're reading, it's just like reading a novel. You just pick up the book and you're just reading line by line. That's not studying. When you're studying means, okay, you read line by line, and then as you're studying, you're taking notes of what you are studying. So as you note things, you can remember them easily. It's something called association in communication psychology, where while you are reading, if you're taking notes, if you are forming mnemonics, which is a very, very good study tips, if you are forming mnemonics, you are most likely to remember what you're reading. Well, I didn't have to read all the time. That was actually the funny thing. I didn't read like every single day I'm reading. No, I always had a way of reading, and that way of reading, by studying, that way of studying helped me. I didn't have to recall too much because I study a lot. I study frequently. It doesn't mean I study every day, but I study like frequently. So when I study, my process of studying, my way of studying allows me to recall what I've just said. Association, as you're reading a particular line, as you're reading a particular note, you look for keywords and you try to associate them with something. You try to form a mnemonic or something instead of cramming. And when you cram, you're most likely to forget what you've read. Do you understand? So you are more likely to, you know, recall what you've read, you know, when you do something called association. So there will be a whole different video for study tips, but this is just an insight into some necessary things I did while writing my WASSCE examination. Another thing I'll mention under study tips as well has to be using practice questions, past questions, past previous from years as far back as 1999, 2000. You have to go back and practice with those questions so you could get a feel of what WASSCE is most likely to set. So the thing most people don't know is that WASSCE doesn't generate questions the same. They don't generate different questions over years. What they do is they look at past questions, and past questions have a pattern. I'm not saying they are going to repeat the same words, but it follows a particular structure. So by the time you practice, you get used to that structure, the way they ask their questions, the way they want you to answer their question. So when you do that, I had a special book just for past question, practice. I had a special book just for that. So when you practice, you get all your past questions for all your 9 subjects. Our advice, get all of them ready for all your 9 subjects, and you begin to practice. So by the time it's time for your WASSCE exam, you will not be under any pressure because you know how they set their questions and you know what to expect. Even though you might not know everything because you didn't set the question, but at least you're going to have a feel of what they are going to set. So that is a very, very important tip. I cannot overemphasize that enough. Please and please get all your past questions for all your 9 subjects and start studying with them today. Another tip under study tips I'm going to mention is using your WASSCE syllabus. Now, because a lot of people usually complain that WASSCE sets out the syllabus, but our advice for all your 9 subjects, if you're not sure of what to read, go online, go to waeconline.org. All right, I'll post the link down in this description, but go to waeconline.org and look for the syllabus of all your subjects. It's all on WAEC website. Look for the syllabus of every subject. Look at what you have to study and try your best to make sure you study for at least all the topics. By doing that, you have a coverage of what WASSCE is going to set, and so you'll be better prepared for the exam and you know, okay, do I have to drop this? Do I have to drop? Because funny enough, not everything in your textbook is actually set in the WASSCE exam. And some things that are not in your textbook could be set in the WASSCE exam. So it's very, very advisable to go online and search for the WASSCE syllabus so you know what to study for. Lastly, the last thing I'll be mentioning before my final thoughts is going to be prayer. So prayer is very important, and I think I became one of the most prayerful persons my life. I became most prayerful in my life when I was about to take examinations, my final examinations. I was so prayerful. Very, very prayerful. Every morning, I always made sure to read the Bible, read some Psalms. And my mom also gave me some prayer books. And I had this anointing oil I usually like do the sign of the cross on my forehead with. And I used to share with my friends sometimes. So I always made sure, and I, very important, I'm a Catholic, so I pray the rosary like very frequently. Sometimes in the morning I wake up and I do everything immediately. I was a prefect, but I try to make sure I supervise quickly, and I leave my hostel, I go to the chapel immediately, pray my rosary before breakfast. So the way I did it was, I'll pray rosary today, I can pray rosary on Monday, and I'll skip Tuesday, I'll pray rosary on Wednesday. I'll skip Thursday, like that. And I was very, very devoted to it. At night, actually, I used to do it at night. Most times, not in the morning, because sometimes, as I mentioned earlier, I'm a prefect. So most times, my work does not allow me to have such space to do such. But I always tried my best to find times to pray, to find times to go to the chapel, sit down and speak with God, and, you know, reflect and meditate to get a clear head. Prayer is very, very important. But there's one major plug I want to get out of the way. Now, a lot of people have this thought that, oh, if I pray, I don't need to read as much. God is going to do it for me. That's crap. If the best advice I could give anyone is, if you're prepared for anything in life, be it an interview, education, anything at all, trust me, luck plays a factor most times. And at the same time, God oversees everything. If you're like true Christian, you know that God oversees everything. But our advice, when you're walking, you walk like there is no God. And as you're praying, you pray like you don't have to work. That's the best advice. That's the best advice my dad always tells me. You pray like you don't have to work, and you work like there is no God. It's very, very important. So please take that into perspective. Don't think that God is going to do it for you. So please, as I've already mentioned, pray like there is no work and work like there is no God. Final thoughts on the video. I'd just like to mention that if you're prepared for the WASSCE exam, I always advise, if you're prepared for an exam, that's why I did this video now. I did this video, this is January, and most likely the WASSCE is going to come in May, June, or even June, July. I'm not really sure about the date, but I did this video now because it's always good to start preparing for anything early. So January to May, that's probably like about 5-6 months. So you have loads of time to prepare to score at least 7 A1s in your WASSCE examination. So our advice, if you're serious about making 9 A1s, our advice, you start preparing for your WASSCE examination today. Start looking for a syllabus, start buying your past questions. And you know, some of the tips I shared in this video, I didn't do them. For instance, I will not lie, I wasn't someone who really had a study schedule. I think I was just very, very organized some way. I always knew when I had to study and where I wanted to study. So I didn't really have, because I'm quite a lazy person sometimes. So I didn't really like write schedules, but it's actually a very good advice, especially if you're not so organized. And that's why I mentioned it. So I didn't really add, but when I talk about study tips, I'll mention some other things. But what I'm trying to say is that please start early. You can't form any miracle. No miracle can happen if you start studying a day before your exam. I don't think there's any miracle that can happen, except probably you've been like, okay, you've been working so hard since your SS1 or grade 10. But please start early to start preparing for this exam. So as I already mentioned, I'll drop the link for your syllabus, the link to check out for your syllabus in the description below. And I also mentioned some textbooks. I'm a science student, so I also mentioned some textbooks that I recommend as well for, you know, preparing for your WASSCE examination. So that will be all for this video. Peace.